दीपक सर।
See the definition. The meaning of integration from a to b f dx when b is less than or equal to a. Earlier we have taken b greater than or equal to a. Now take b less than or equal to a. Suppose f is your bounded and integrable function on this closed interval b a. Since b is less than a, therefore b is here and a is here for a greater than b. Then we define integration from a to b f dx as minus times integration from b to a f dx where a is greater than b. Also, integration from a to b f dx will be zero when a equal to b. These are the two definitions. Now come to inequalities for integrals. Earlier we have shown that this result is true for a bounded integrable function f, means small m into b minus a is less than or equal to integration from a to b f dx, which is less than or equal to capital M into b minus a when b is greater than or equal to a. Here our integral limit of integration is from a to b and our bounded interval is a b. Now if b is less than a, means the interval will be b a, so that a is greater than b, then m into a minus b will be less than or equal to integration from b to a f dx, and it will be less than or equal to capital M into a minus b when a is greater than b. So you just need to exchange this a with b. Now see what is the next part. It implies that minus times m into a minus b is greater than or equal to minus times integration from f b to a f dx, which is greater than or equal to minus times m a minus b. Since we multiply here with minus sign, minus 1, therefore this inequality will change from less than or equal to greater than or equal to. So it implies that m into b minus a is greater than or equal to integration from a to b f dx greater than or equal to capital M into b minus a when b is less than a, means this a is greater than b, lower integral, lower limit is greater than upper limit. Now there are some results which you should remember. See here, first result: if f is bounded and integrable on closed interval a b, then there exists a number lambda lying between the bounds of small f and between the bounds of f, means between small m and capital F, between small m and capital F of f, such that integration from a to b f dx will be lambda times b minus a. This lambda is greater or equal to small m and less than or equal to capital M. So it is, this lambda is between the bounds of m f. See the deduction too. If your function f is continuous and integrable on closed interval a b, then there exists a number c between a and b, such that this integration from a to b f dx will be fc into b minus a, where the fc with where this c is between a and b, means c is greater than or equal to a, less than or equal to b, and this fc is between fa and fb. Now deduction 3: if f is bounded and integrable on closed interval ab and this small k is a number such that mod fx less than or equal to k for all x in closed interval ab, then modulus of integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to k times modulus of b minus a. See here its solution. Suppose capital M and small m be the bounds of fx. Now it is given that modulus of fx is less than or equal to small k. See here it is given for all x in closed interval ab. This is given to you. It means meaning of this inequality is minus k less than or equal to fx less than or equal to k. You can check it. Take first it positive and then take it negative. So it implies that minus k will be less than or equal to small m. It will be less than or equal to fx, less than or equal to capital M, less than or equal to small k. Since small m and capital M are bounds of f, and k is such that mod fx is less than or equal to k. So this implies this one, which for b greater than or equal to a implies that minus k into b minus a multiply by b minus a. So minus k into b minus a will be less than or equal to small m into b minus a, which will be less than or equal to integration from a to b f dx, which is less than or equal to capital M b minus a and less than or equal to k into b minus a. So it implies that modulus of integration from a to b f dx is less than or equal to k into b minus a. See, this minus k b minus a, this is plus k b minus a, and this is integration from a to b f dx. So it will be implying that modulus of integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to k into b minus a, as earlier we have seen here. If b is less than a, this situation is different. Means here b is greater than or equal to, here b is less than a. It means a will be greater than b, so that modulus of integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to k into a minus b. Just exchange both of them. This is in limit of integration is from b to a. It implies that modulus of integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to k into b minus a. Since it is modulus, so no change. We can exchange a and b together. Next, deduction 4. See, deduction 4. If the function f is bounded and integrable on closed interval a b, and fx is greater than or equal to 0 for all x in closed interval a b. Since fx is greater than or equal to 0 and a is less than or equal to b, therefore integration from a to b f dx will be greater than or equal to 0 if b is greater than or equal to a, first. And second, it will be less than or equal to 0 if b is less than or equal to a. See, it is very clear. Since f is our greater than or equal to 0, so it will be greater than or equal to 0. And if b is greater than or equal to a, then interval this integration will be greater than or equal to 0. And if this b is less than or equal to a, then it will be less than or equal to 0. Since fx is greater than or equal to 0 for all x in closed interval ab, therefore the lower bound small m will be greater than or equal to 0. It is clear. Now see deduction 4. If there are two functions f and g and both are bounded and integrable on closed interval ab, such that f is greater than or equal to g, then integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to integration from a to b g dx when b is greater than or equal to a. See, this is an important question or deduction. It has been asked several times. And also integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to integration from a to b g dx when b is less than or equal to a. See, it is given that f is greater than or equal to g. It implies that f minus g will be greater than or equal to 0 for all x in this closed interval a b. Hence, from our deduction 4, we will have integration from a to b f minus g dx greater than or equal to 0 if b is greater than or equal to a, or integration from a to b f dx will be greater than or equal to integration from a to b g dx if b is greater than or equal to a, since it is coming from our deduction 4. What is our deduction 4? Deduction 4 is this one. When f is greater than or equal to 0, then integration from a to b f dx will be greater than or equal to 0 for b greater than or equal to a, and less than or equal to 0 for b less than or equal to a. So it is clear. Or similarly, integration from a to b f dx will be less than or equal to integration from a to b g dx if b is less than or equal to a. This is another case. Here b is greater than or equal to a, but here b is less than or equal to a. So this inequality sign will change from greater than or equal to less than or equal to. So it is clear. Note, we have assumed the result that integration from a integration f minus g dx will be equal to integration f dx minus integration g dx. Using this result, you apply this result over this and get to this conclusion. So it will be proved later on. After this, we will have refinement of partitions, and it will be discussed with you in your next class. Till now, if you have any query or any difficulty or any problem, you can ask me your questions here. Also, this lecture will be available on my YouTube channel. Go to my YouTube channel, watch the video, and if you have any doubt or query, note down the time and the difficulty and ask me your problem in the comment section or in my your WhatsApp number. There is a comment tab in every YouTube video. You can also send your query there, type the comment and write your questions there. So it is okay from my side for today. And if you have any difficulty, you just note down and ask me your questions.